Dr. Foster fans were left on the edge of their seats as the penultimate episode ended on a major cliffhanger. By Natasha Sporn Tuesday, September 26, 2017, after losing Kate Parks to France, after she discovered his infidelity, Simon Foster raged against his estranged ex for breaking his family apart. But, in an unexpected turn, Simon decided to go and see his son with Gemma, after finding out the hotel Tom has been staying at. Unwilling to let him get to their son, Gemma got in her car and sped off down the road, determined to get to the troubled teen. However, as Simon was walking down the road and came into focus, Gemma revved up her car as she careered towards Bertie Carvel's character, who had just reaffirmed that he would only leave Parminster in a coffin. Viewers immediately rushed to Twitter to talk about the cliffhanger and demand next week's concluding episode be aired at once. Processing the scene, one fan posted he said the only one he'll leave town is in a coffin, so she's going to run him over. I can't. Oh my god. Dr. Foster. While another surprised user commented, run him over, run him over, run him over, Dr. Foster. Oh my god, I'm an awful human being, just shouted run him over at the top of my lungs, Dr. Foster, gasped somebody else. Elsewhere, in last week's episode of Dr. Foster, Gemma had hate sex with estranged ex Simon in the home they used to share. Despite not recording the act as first intended, Gemma made sure that Bertie Carvel's character's infidelity was exposed to wife Kate Parks, played by Jodie Comer, and set about revealing all by mailing Simon's tie back to her. After lying to Gemma and her own parents to defend Simon and say that he had come clean about being unfaithful, Kate gave her cheating husband the chance to come clean, but he instead continued to lie. Later, Kate reached the end of her tether as she berated Simon for still being obsessed with Gemma, from their wedding song to Kate's clothes, and vowed to take herself and their daughter to France and cut him out of their life for good. Before speeding away, the 25-year-old character said, "What did you think would happen that I wouldn't find out? You said it was just sex, but this is all for her. That was your one and last chance. It was all there, Mark and Dad helping us. You just had to manage being normal for 2 years. Making a go of it, it all could have been yours. The house, the business, everything you ever wanted. You just had to love me and your daughter for 2 years. You are never going to see me again. You are never going to see Amelie again. We're all moving to France, to a house there. And we'll hire very expensive lawyers to explain to anyone who needs to know why she is growing up without her father." Dr. Foster concludes next Tuesday at 9 p.m. on BBC One.